Properly done, medical group management is neither a collaborative nor a unanimous process. It's a leadership decision. The problem is that many groups have created an almost impermeable barrier to true leadership within their entity. They strive for a consensus, which by its very nature is just another way of saying watered down decision. The fact is that there is no way of reaching consensus unless there's enough give and take from the original concept to allow enough members to buy in to the consensus outcome, which is often only the beginning point in another negotiation, this time with a third party. Or they set up a facially strong governance system, but then fall back into the consensus trap. Or they construct a proper governance structure in which a small group, three individuals let's say, are the governing board, or in which a strong leader, for example the president or managing partner, is empowered to make operational decisions, only to have a shareholders agreement or partnership document that gives every owner a de facto veto over major decisions. Every business, and yes, your medical group is a business, needs a streamlined way to make day-to-day management decisions. And it can't allow one or two or even a few dissenters to hold the group back in the event of major action, such as a sale or merger. The time to think about this is now, unless now is the eve of an important decision, in which case, it's too late. If you haven't already, get my book, The Medical Group Management Matrix, which is available both on Amazon or as a complimentary download on my website, advisorylawgroup.com. It provides you both a diagnostic tool and a roadmap to better medical group management.